Welcome to Mountain Strong. Today we are at Jewel Lake, which is a park in the southern part of the city of Anchorage, and we're getting a nice look at breakup here in Alaska. A lot of the snow has melted off now, but you can see the ice here on the lake is beginning to melt. There was even a sign when I pulled up that said, warning, thin ice. I've never been told so quickly that I was on thin ice, but there you go. Well, anyway, this is another reminder of how accessible God's beauty is, and so I just want to encourage you once again to get out and see all of the wonderful things that God has made around you. Today we're going to be having a look together at Psalm 46. Psalm 46, let's go ahead and read. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her when morning dawns. The nations rage, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord, how he has brought desolations on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Some of you who are watching this video might have followed the news a few months back when Anchorage was actually struck with a massive earthquake. The Sunday following that earthquake, I actually preached on this particular psalm. How often do you get to use an event as relevant as an earthquake in your introduction? It doesn't happen all the time. And so I was thankful to find Psalm 46 and find where the psalmist pictured the earth shaking and everything giving way. Sometimes it helps in approaching biblical literature to be aware of symbols that are used throughout the Old Testament in particular, and even into the New Testament to some degree. You find that one of the symbols of the Old Testament is a mountain. A mountain is a symbol of strength and stability. And so when a mountain is moved, that's pretty massive. And that's why Jesus used that illustration to describe the power of our faith. When a mountain is cast into the sea, you can picture something great, something mighty, something stable being lost. What would that make you feel like? Well, that's the emotion that the psalmist is trying to conjure up. Something very dear to him is at risk of being lost. And so how can he describe that to people? Well, he describes it like a mountain being cast into the sea. But notice how this psalm has three pauses. And after talking about the earth shaking and mountains being cast into the sea, what does the psalmist do? He pauses. And then he reflects upon something. He reflects upon the stability that he has as a part of the city of God. He says, I'm in Jerusalem. This is where God's habitation is. This is where the temple is. And because God is here, though the nations rage, the kingdoms totter, what's going to happen to me? Well, I'm going to be provided for. And I love the way that this is pictured. You know, the mountains are tumbling into the sea. That's chaos, right? What do people worry about in times of chaos? It was interesting, the day of the earthquake, we stayed at home that day because we knew exactly what was going to happen. Whenever there is any kind of catastrophe or calamity, people descend upon stores and they buy up all that they possibly can, but especially one thing in particular, water. But notice how the city of God, it's stable, and what does it have? There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God. It's got its water. It's provided for. Everything is taken care of. Everything is looked after. This city is stable. It's secure. It's safe. And even though everything is shaking around, this city is not going to be moved. In fact, there's a purposeful contrast there. In verse 2, it says, though the mountains be moved, verse 5, she, that is the city of God, will not be moved. Sometimes God's people shake when there is no reason to shake. I picture those actors and actresses when, you know, they're trying to pretend like there's an earthquake, how they're trembling about the place and moving around. There's no real earthquake. The camera's shaking, the actors are shaking and moving, but nothing is really happening. And that's true when difficulties face God's people. because though the earth shakes, God's people remain secure and safe. We are kept by the power of God. And so I love then how the figurative, after that second pause, then transitions into the literal. Okay, the city of God is secure and safe. Well, what does that mean? Well, it means in verses 8 and 9 that God wins wars. You know, God's people are engaged in real battles, real struggles, and face real difficulties. But our God is equipped to win those battles and win the wars. We are mighty, and our weapons are able to cast down strongholds with our God. God does not move, and so He commands His people to be still and know that I am God. Don't be an actor shaking when nothing is moving. God is still there, and therefore you have no reason to move or fear. And so He says, be still and know that I am God. And He concludes in verse 12 by saying, the Lord of hosts is with us, the God of Jacob is our fortress. And we can't think of any place safer or better to be. May God bless you today.